The Memorandum of Understanding signed between the Private Sector Foundation of Uganda and the Uganda Industrial Research Institute is intended to implement the Generating Growth Opportunities and Productivity for Women Enterprises Growth Project. The five-year project funded by the World Bank targets women in production, value addition and trade.
I'm sure most of you must have learned a thing or two.
Speaking at the event, the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, revealed that whereas Ugandan women are actively engaged in entrepreneurship, majority of them are in the informal sector, and this is simply because they have limited capital.
That's why when you move around this country, you will find at the side, people are there, women are there selling tomatoes, selling onions, crafts and all that. And what do you need to do to move women from the informal sector to the formal sector? Number one is that woman who has started a business, for them to move, they need to grow their business with cheap capital. Most of you are borrowing at 24%, 30% per year. Others are borrowing monthly, paying monthly interest rate of 5%. There are those even in the villages who tell me they even borrow at 10% per month.
Under the project, women entrepreneurs will have access to free training in value addition, trade and marketing, packaging and branding, among others, in the production chain. Women across the country have been urged to embrace this project for better livelihood.
We realize that there is no way you can grow your business without money. You need the money. So if you need the money, as government, we need to look for cheap capital for women. So the first intervention, which will be very crucial for you who are innovators here, is that we shall have the cluster, the sub-project that will give you cheap capital for your program, for your businesses. And already we have had a meeting and said that interest should not exceed 10% per year.
Professor Charles Kwesiga, the executive director of the Uganda Industrial Research Institute, urges women entrepreneurs to embrace innovation and technology in their production, as this will ensure that they have quality products.
We have to develop the human capital necessary to run those technologies and manage them. Highly skilled manpower. It's not uncommon for us to get engineers who are well educated with magnificent grades, some even with honors degrees, but when he comes to this center, he sees a CNC machine for the first time.
We need to ensure that the products made in Uganda, and in this case for women, are of quality, which is why, as Private Sector Foundation, as GROW, we are going to partner with UNBS to ensure that women's products are certified. You cannot penetrate any market without that certification. But now women can access this certification of the product free of charge.
The 2021 MasterCard Index of Women Entrepreneurs ranked Uganda among the countries with the highest number of women owning businesses, coming after Botswana. The same report indicates that women in Uganda stand out as an excellent example of women's determination to provide for themselves and their families despite facing financial, regulatory and technical challenges. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.